today we are going to talk about the Pythagorean theorem. As you can see in this picture here, this is a right angle triangle. And for any right angle triangle, there's always a formula to find the length of any of the sides if any two other sides, the length of any two other sides is given. And therefore, we have this theory, mathematics law, Pythagorean theorem, known as a square plus b square is equal to c square. So what is the things you need to take note when you apply this formula? So there's only one thing for you to note. First, they are right angle triangle. And next, c is the longest side. C is the longest side. We call it hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, this is the longest side. So for example, right now, if A and B is given, how do we find the length of the side C? It would be C is equivalent to the square root of A squared plus B squared. Now, this video today is not to teach you how to find, because I'm sure that you have learned this formula and you know how to use this formula to find out the length of the longest side. The purpose of this video is mainly to introduce you about this Pythagorean triples. As you can see here, this is a group, and in each group, many groups of numbers, and in each group, they are three numbers. We call it triples. So what is so special about Pythagorean triples? Okay, so they are three positive integers. Integers means there is no decimal number, It won't be like 3.1 or 4.1. No, because they are a whole number, no decimal. A, B, C. Alright, so this is the label, the triples. As you can see here, 3 is the shortest side, followed by 4 and 5. Once you have memorized all these Pythagorean triples, right, you will manage to solve problems regarding Pythagorean theorem very, very fast. Okay, so let me repeat again. This is one of the way to find the length of any side in right angle triangle, or under a certain condition, if it fulfills any of these Pythagorean theorem, you will manage to find out the length of each side very quick. So now, for now, I would like you to look at these four groups of the triples here. 3, 4, 5, 5, 12, 13, 7, 24, 25, 8, 15, 17. What does it mean? So there are actually a lot of triples, but the first four triples here are the most common ones. So what it means is like this, 3, 4, 5. If this is 7, this is 24, and what will be the length of this side, the unknown side here? So without using calculator, what is this, the length of this side here? Yes, it is 25. Why 25? Because you have memorized the list of the triples, 7, 24, 25. So without using calculator, I know that, oh, this is 25. Why? Because it is part of the Pythagorean triples. Or if you insist to use calculator, you will still manage to find it. X equals to 7 squared plus 24 squared bracket, and you square root the whole thing, you will still manage to get 25. Alright, so now, what you need to do, you will need to look at these four groups of triples, memorize it before I move on to the next slide. You may also pause this video to remember the three groups of the numbers. Alright, so now that you have done, we are going to move on to the exercise. Alright. Okay, so as you can see here, this is 3, 4. Can you tell me what is the length of this C side here? Yes, it is 5 cm. Why? Because according to these triples here, it is 3, 4, 5. The longest side is the largest number. Of course, it is the largest number, right? So, 3, 4, and 5. How about this? Okay, although this triangle is slightly smaller, it does not fit the ratio, especially when 3 cm is here. But what we want to highlight here is the ratio thingy, the number. So what is the length of C? As you can see here, the C, it is 6 cm, 8 cm, and it is C here. So this one, it fits the ratio of 3, 4, and 5. So by looking at this ratio, you know that the C is actually 10 cm. I am doing this by memorizing the Pythagorean triples without even using calculator. But of course, this cannot solve all the problems, especially when the side, the length of the sides here is decimal number. Still, you can solve it by using calculator in the same formula. Alright, now let's carry on. Okay, so this one done. Now, this is the question. This side here is 5, this is 12. What is the x? X is 13. Why? Because 5, 12, 13. Okay, so this is it. But again, let's say if this is a test, right, you are required to show your working. So what is the purpose of memorizing the triples? It helps you to solve the problem in a faster way. Although you still need to show your working. Okay, that being said, you still need to know how to solve the Pythagorean theorem or apply this formula manually. Alright? And now, this one. Can any of you tell me what is the value of x here? So you see, this is 15. 15, 20, and x being the longest side. Does it fit the ratio of 3, 4, 5? It is. So 5x is actually 25 because 5 times 5 makes 25. Ta-da! Is it very easy? Alright, now let us look at more questions. So as you can see here, this length side here is 15. This is the hypotenuse. And this is 9. So, again, this is the hypotenuse, right? How do we find the length QR? QR is actually 12 cm. Why? Because, again, 3, 4, 5, 9, 12, 15. So QR is actually 12. I'm going to write it straight away here. This is 12 cm. Now, how do we find the value of x here? It is a right angle triangle like this. This is P, Q, and S. S. And this is 9, 18. So how do we solve this? So for this one, we have got no choice but to solve it by using calculator. So the length of PS is 9 square plus 18 square root and bracket and then square root the whole thing. 81 plus 18 square, you get 325. But again, since it is bracket, we are going to solve the expression in the operation in the bracket first. It is plus 81. You will get the square root of 405, which is equivalent to 20.12. This is the final answer. Normally in maths, right, if this is the final answer, we will tend to double underline it. Alright, so this is the solution. Alright, so that is it for today.